Hannibal drove the Romans to the brink of despair and defeat. His genius was such that even today, his battle tactics are studied in military colleges around the world.
What is now modern-day Tunisia, the great military strategist Hannibal's father was a general who compelled his son to swear undying hatred against the Roman Empire. Hannibal became a commander at the age of 26 and worked to consolidate his base of power in Iberia, modern-day Spain. In 219 BC, Hannibal's attack on the town of Sanctum was used by the Romans as a pretense to declare war on his people, sparking the Second Punic War. Hannibal would amass a force of over 100,000 troops and almost 40 war elephants and lead them through the Alps toward Rome. Enough cannot be said about how his use of elephants facing horrific weather conditions, mountainous terrain, and attacks from the region's natives, which Hannibal would reach the other side after a harrowing 15 days. His force now numbered a fraction of its original size, with a mere 20,000 infantry, 6,000 cavalry, and only one surviving elephant. He got his rep off at this victory in the Second Punic War. Hannibal would battle Roman armies in Italian territory. He would enlist the aid of several of Rome's allies in this campaign that at one point occupied a significant portion of the Italian peninsula, but never took Rome itself. He ended his campaign to return home to defend his people against a Roman invasion. It was a conflict that he would lose due to his enemy's adoption of turning his own tactics to defeat Hannibal. After accepting Rome's terms, Hannibal became a politician. Rome would become weary of Hannibal's increasing influence and demanded in 195 BC that he resign from office. As a result, Hannibal would move to Ephesus, present-day Turkey, where he would lead multiple campaigns against Roman interests and allies. After a failed military campaign against Roman ally Pergamon, he would take poison himself in order to avoid being taken by the enemy. Hannibal executed a battle action plan that played to his army's strength and against his opponent's weakness. He was able to forge alliances with local tribes who had once been allies of Rome. While he won many battles, he never took the city of Rome and failed to repel the Roman invasion. But to quote one of the greatest military minds to exist, Hannibal, we either find a way or we make one.
And now you know, and no one's 120 degrees of the cipher. Add on